Hello everyone, and welcome to How to Paint Like Harlem Renaissance Creator Aaron Douglas, Explain the Bob Ross Style. So I'm just going to start this off simply with a ruler, and I'm just going to sketch in two lines here that are going to act as sort of a beam of light. And then so, I'm going to set my scene in a hilly area, so using my pencil I'm just going to sketch in some hills. Just like this. I'll just erase this really quickly. And so I'll put some examples of Aaron Douglas's work up on the screen here. And so a lot of times in his artwork, he liked to focus on having a singular person be the main focus of the artwork. And so that's what we're going to try to resemble here today, is that aspect of having one person sort of be that prominent figure, and we'll build the artwork around them. And we want to focus on not being super avid on looking at the details, but more of overall being like Aaron Douglas and using different colors to create a bigger picture. And so here I'm just going to sketch in, like you see here, like a little divot, just to make it look like sort of our person is looking up at this beam of light. And then to finish off this sketch, I'm just gonna put in some squiggly lines here, because why not? And then we'll kind of make a sun looking like area at the top. And so now that we have our preliminary sketch, we can now start to shade in. And I'm gonna be using watercolors today, but that doesn't mean that you have to, as you can use either maybe a Crayola marker or just some simple crayons. You can still resemble Aaron Douglas's artwork. And then, just for the sake of time, since I do only have 10 minutes, I will just be cutting some parts of while I'm shading so that I can fit this artwork into that 10-minute time period. But a little bit of some background on Aaron Douglas is that he was born in Topeka, Kansas, and his mother was actually an artist. And then so he was heavily influenced by her because she also liked to paint with watercolors. And so he found a love for art from a young age from his mother. And so I finished shading in this area here, and I'll move on to the last section. I'm gonna use this nice light green. I think this is really nice of a color, and I'll just use this to shade in this last area so you can get to that as well as I do this. And so now that I've finished shading in this area with this green, I'm actually going to take some of this blue over and use it in this area to kind of create a new different color, because that's what Aaron Douglas is all about, is using different colors and being expressive to create new colors on the canvas. Or in this case, the paper. It's about spreading the love, not the hate, through this artwork. We want to be expressive with the colors. And then so now, I think it can be time to move on to our character here. And so what Aaron Douglas was about in a lot of his artworks was focusing in on a single person and kind of using colors to make that person pop. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a nice hot pink color here to try to make this person pop on the paper, and I'll be back when I'm done with that. And so now that we've got our character filled in, I'm going to go over here to this top corner where we have our sun, and I'm going to use this nice yellowy color. I'm just going to make it pop just like this. I'm going to color this in, make this area pop here. And then so some more on Aaron Douglas is that his career starts to take off in the 1930s, and then especially in 1935 is when he became a prominent member of the Harlem Renaissance. And so with that, in 1935, he became the president of the Harlem Artists Guild, which he also helped form. And so their aim and goal was to try to help promote, foster, and support young African-American artists and they also wanted to help improve the public understanding of issues that were faced by the African American community, like poverty, racism, and unemployment. So during that time period, you can start to see Aaron Douglas's career and legacy to take off and form, and you see what kind of effect his artwork starts to have on the world. And so now we can move on to some of the bigger areas of this artwork. And so one thing too is that you don't have to use the same colors that I'm using. It's all about what you feel like you want to do. So I'm painting this blue, but if you want to go for a purple, go for a purple. It's all about how you see it and how you want to express yourself. That's the beauty of Aaron Douglas, is you get to do what you want to do. We're trying to emulate him. Express yourself how you want to be expressed. And so I'll be back when I finish this area. All right, so I finished up this section here. And so don't worry, you can always pause if you need some extra time. But I think now I'm going to do this next section with this lighter green color. I think this will look especially nice on the paper and also give some good contrast to the other areas of what we have going on so far. And then so, just another reminder is, don't get too caught up on making everything perfect. Just focus on expression, because that's what this is all about. Alrighty, so now that I have that section finished, we can move on to this last portion here. And I'm going with this nice blue choice. But yet again, it's really up to what you want to do and how you see this art. So if you're digging a hot pink, maybe like a nice dark blue, go with that. So it's about what you want to do. So just do you. But the last step of this is going to be is this beam of sunshine here. I want to make this more prominent in the artwork. So what I want to do, I'm going to take this color on the palette. This looks especially beautiful. So I'm going to take this color and see if I can go over the artwork with it and see if I can make this beam of sunshine stick out more and see what I can do with that and see what it does to the painting. So I'll be back with what this looks like and how I made this pop a little bit more. So I finished with the beam of light, as you can see, and I think it just looks especially cool as it's really kind of popping out in the image and this picture that I've created here, and hopefully yours too. And I think that's just really cool. And now I'm just gonna do some finishing touches, just make things look a little bit smoother in this art. You can go ahead and finish any shading that you need while I do this too. And then just lastly, a little bit more on Aaron Douglas and the legacy that he left is that Douglas is sometimes referred to as being the father of Black American art. And so he was a central figure in the development of the artistic expression that generations of African American artists used as a way of presenting their identity and culture to combat racism. And elements from Douglas's artwork would go on to influence other African American artists who had the same goal of using art as a way of combating oppression. And Aaron Douglas was just really influential, as he not only impacted the art world of his time with his paintings, but he also helped foster and create the next generation of artists. And so I think that's just especially powerful, is the impact that Aaron Douglas left. And we should just really acknowledge what Aaron Douglas did for the art community during the time of the Harlem Renaissance. And so after letting my art dry for a little bit, this is the final result. And so I hope you all had fun, learned a little something, and most importantly, created something beautiful. What I want.